Yes, hello, good morning to all of you again. So, continuation lang nung ating topic regarding dun sa ating 2D and 3D, 3-dimensional motion. So, ang isang example natin doon last time is the projectile motion, wherein the path is trajectory line. Okay, so this time ay pag-aaralan naman natin kapag ka hindi trajectory line yung ating path. Okay, so motion in 2 or 3 dimensions again. So before that, so alamin muna natin kung ano ba yung position and velocity vector. So when we say in 2D and 3D motion, so very particular dyan and necessary nating malaman yung mga position vectors and velocity vectors. But before velocity vectors, alamin natin muna yung position vectors. So yun yung pinag-aralan natin nung mga unang topic natin, ano. So yun yung kahalagahan ng vectors sa ating pinag-aaralan na physics, ano. So first, position vector. Position vector is denotes as the small letter r and may arrowhead. Kasi yung position vector is vector quantity siya. So displacement siya or position siya. Okay? And naka-unit vector form siya or component form. It is equals to xi hat plus yj hat plus zk hat. And from our previous discussion, the x is the x component, y is the y component, and the z is the z component of the position vectors. Okay, so paano natin aalamin pa ng mas malinaw yan? So let's say for example, so yung ating body ay nasa isang position. So, sa isang position lang muna tayo. Ito yung position na yan. So, kapag nag-displace na, or lumakad na, or nag-move na, halimbawa, let's say, pumunta siya dito. So, may displacement nang nangyari. Okay? And displacement, ito na yan. So, from starting point to end point. Okay? But, before that, alamin muna natin kung ano ba yung position vector. So, position vector is from our previous discussion, ito yung ating position, ano, in terms of component. So ito yun, no? So na mayroong x component, so meaning if we have a three dimension coordinate plane, the x, y, and z, ano, so yung I is in the direction of x, yung j hat is in the direction of y, and yung z, yung k hat is in the direction of what? Z-axis, okay? And yung mga component nun ay yun yung value, okay? Let's say for example, ito yung xi hat. So yung papunta dito, okay? So yung point 1 daw, position P of particle at a given time has coordinate x, y, and z. Ito na yun, okay? So x component, y component, and the z component. Nandun yung kanyang position. Ngayon, kapag gumalaw na siya, halimbawa, papunta dito, ayun, dun magkakaroon na ng velocity vectors kasi magkakaroon na ng displacement. Okay? So, sunod natin ngayon si velocity vectors. Ayan. Velocity vectors ay designate natin is small letter b and may arrowhead sa taas that denotes direction. No? Then, average. So, average muna ang pag-aralan natin. Average velocity vectors. So, in our previous topic, average x velocity yung ating unang pinag-aralan. So, similar lang ito. So, average dito, meaning, pwede siyang gumalaw in the direction of x, in the direction of y, and also in the direction of z simultaneously. Okay? And average velocity vector is equivalent to position 2 minus position 1 over time interval t2 minus t1. Okay, so sinabi kong position, hindi distance, ha? Kasi position, vector siya, no? Pagka si distance, scalar siya, no? So maliwanag yon, dapat yung r sub 2 natin and r sub 1 or kahit anong r, yun ay position. Okay, and it is equals to delta r over delta t, and that is our average velocity vector. So vector dapat ito ay in terms of component vector or meron siyang direction, okay? And paano natin malalaman 'yan? So kanina, so yung position vector ay inalam lang natin, 0.1 pa lang 'yon. Ay ngayon, kung gumalaw yung body or object papunta doon sa P2, then therefore magkakaroon tayo ng velocity, ano? And sabi ko dun sa ating mga previous topic, point to point, from point 1 to point 2, from starting point to end point, ay average velocity. Okay? And last time, on the x-axis tayo, so average x velocity yung pinag-aralan natin last time. So ngayon is average velocity. So meaning x, y, z tayo. Okay, displacement vector, delta r, ito yun. Yan, yun yung delta r, okay? And yung delta t is yung time pamula dito up to p2, okay? From t2 minus t1, okay? So ito yun, okay? Then position at time t1, ito yun, position at time t2, okay? So napakasimple lang. And the particle spot, ito yon, nagalaw siya. Hindi straight line. So, pinakita na hindi straight line kasi kahit magpapunta-punta dito yan, basta magpagayang-gayang yan, doon din ang punta. So, iisa pa din yung ating displacement. Ano? Okay? And therefore, iisa pa din yung ating average velocity. Okay? Yan. So, next is, since alam natin yung average velocity na, then therefore, aralin natin yung mas malalim pa, which is the instantaneous velocity vector or the velocity at a given instant. Meaning, ito yung velocity or the limit of the average velocity as the time interval approaches zero. Okay? Ito yung definition niya. So, the limit of average velocity as the time interval approaches zero. Okay? And it is also equal to derivative nung position. Okay, let's say for example we have a given of equation r is equal to 0.5 t. So in terms of t, then therefore we can find the value for the velocity agad dahil r na yung given. So i-derivative lang natin itong r in terms of t. So ito yon. Then therefore, kuha agad si instantaneous velocity. Pero how about kung hindi given yung r? Hindi given yung r in terms of t. Ang given ay x, y, z in terms of t lahat. So ganito yung definition niyan. So ito yung movement ng ating motion nung path. Ito yon. Yan siya. And from our previous discussion, the instantaneous velocity is the slope or the tangent line to the curve. Okay? Since ito yung curve, yan. So, instantaneous velocity daw, ito yung path eh. Ito yung path ng ating ano. Yun yung travel, yun yung line. So, hindi siya trajectory line, unlike dun sa projectile motion. Okay? So, hindi trajectory line. So, this is the motion in a three-dimensional plane. Okay? So, ito yung path from P1 to P2. So, yung kinuha natin kanina is the average velocity. So, pamula P2 hanggang P1 yon. Ngayon naman, ang kinukuha natin is instantaneous velocity. Wherein yung time interval is approaches zero. Meaning yung P2 is palalapitin mo ng palalapitin dito sa P1. Okay? And po-produce yun ng concept na yung ating instantaneous velocity ay yung tangent line dun sa curve. Okay? Meaning, in the x, y, z plane, kapag nandun yung ating particle spot, so yung tangent line doon is equal to the instantaneous velocity or velocity vector itself. So dito sa ating physics nga pala ay kapag sinabing velocity lang, nakarinig kayo ng velocity lang or nakabasa, meaning instantaneous velocity yon, ano? hindi siya average velocity. Okay? Mas interesting pag-aralan yung instantaneous velocity kasi yun yung velocity at a given point at a given instant, okay? So, kanina ay may R tayo in terms of T. So, paano kapag X, Y, Z naman? So, ganito mangyayari. So, let's say, for example, meron tayong X, Y, and Z. So, all in terms of time yan. Lahat yan ay in terms of time, okay? So, meaning kung in terms of time yan, so, kung tangent line dito, o mga slope, meaning kailangan natin magkunin yung first derivative. Okay? Kasi tangent line yung hinahanap natin, first derivative, just to get the value of velocity component. Ano? So, magkakaroon, mahihiwag yung ating velocity into three components. Ano? Bx, By, and Bc. So, Bx is equals to dx or derivative of x with respect to t, and Vy, derivative of y with respect to t, and Bc with respect to t. So, yun yung Bc, By, and Bx. So, kapag ginamitan natin ang Pythagorean theorem yan, makukuha natin si velocity or the instantaneous velocity vector. Okay? Which is also equal to dun. Okay? So, kaya makakakuha tayo ng equation na ganyan. So, itong equation na to, ito siya. So, equal din siya dito. Kaya yan. And also, equal din siya dito sa term na ito. Okay? So, kung itong velocity natin is nasa component vector, so, I, J, K yan. I hat, J hat, K hat. And then, the X component, Y component, and Z component siya. Okay? Ayan. Kung dx dt, yun yung x component ni velocity. And itong dy dt, yun yung y component ulit ni velocity. And then, dc dt, yun yung z component ni velocity. So, mga component pa lang yan. So, ito yung ating magnitude mismo ng velocity. Gagamitan natin ng Pythagorean theorem. So, bx squared plus bx squared plus bz squared. Yun lang yun. So, napakasimple. Parang ganun lang din dun sa ating discussion last time. Ano? So, example, a robotic vehicle or rover is exploring the surface of Mars. So, nasa Mars daw. So, nag-i-explore daw. So, gaya na nangyayari ngayon, pinag-aaralan nila yung Mars. Okay? The stationary Mars lander, so lander, yung nag-land dun sa Mars, okay? Is the origin of the coordinates. So, yun yung gagawin nating origin, ano? And the surrounding Martian surface, so may surface daw dun na kung tawagin ay Martian, lies in XY plane. So, isinet natin na yung surface na yun is in the XY plane lang. So, two-dimensional tayo, okay? So, the rubber which we represent as a point has x and y coordinates that vary with time. Ayan. So, x and y vary with time. So, xy plane lang. So, similar lang din yung, at yung computation or process kapag xyz plane tayo o dimension. Xyz o 3D. Okay? Same lang yung process. So, xy lang this time. XY lang yung given, pero kung dadagdagan pa natin ng Z coordinates, 3D na yung ating computation. Parehas lang din. So, madadagdagan lang ng Z. Kasi, di ba, velocity X is equal to dx dt and velocity Y is dy dt and velocity at Z axis is dc dt. Okay? Ayan. So, may given. So, nagbabari yung ating position. Ang position x ay nagbabari with respect to time at 2.0 meter minus 0.25 meter per second squared t squared. And y, yung position y ay nagbabari ulit. Multiply equals to 1.0 meter per second times t plus 0.025 meter per second cube t cube. Okay? So, ito yung equation ng ating position. So, naglalakbay yung sa surface, ano, dun sa Martian surface, sa XY plane lang tayo. Pero kung dadagdagan natin yan ng Z in terms of time ulit, ay ganun din yung computation na mangyayari. Ano? Ganun din sa gagawin natin dito. Okay. And yung tanong ay ito. Find the rover's coordinates and distance from the lander at t is equals to 2 seconds. So, in terms of t naman tayo, so madali lang yan, ano, coordinates lang. So, x, y plane. So, in our geometry, ang coordinates is x, y. Okay? So, kailangan natin kunin si x kasi may 2 seconds naman tayo. Direct substitution doon. Then, y. Ganun ulit. Direct substitution. Makukuha natin si coordinates. Okay, yun yung tanong sa A. And also yung distance from the lander. So, yung distance is the distance from the starting point or at certain point to the final point. Ano? Target point. Okay? So, distance. So, yan. Magdi-distance formula lang tayo doon. Okay? Then, B, find the rover's displacement and average velocity. Vectors. So, vectors yung tanong. Meaning, ay component vector siya, may mga I hat, J hat, Z hat siya. But this time, hanggang I hat, J hat lang tayo kasi X, Y plane lang. Okay. For the interval, T is equals to 0.0 seconds to T is equals to 2.0 seconds. So, from T is equals to 0 daw to T is equals to 2 seconds. So, yun yung i-analyze natin. Ano? Displacement vector and average velocity vectors na kukunin natin doon, ano. Then letter C, ang tanong is find a general expression of the rover's instantaneous velocity vector B. Okay, express velocity at t is equals to 2 seconds in component form and in terms of magnitude and direction. Okay, so simulan natin. Unang tanong, find the rover's coordinates and distance from the lander at t is equals to 2 seconds. So, yung lander, yan yung ating origin na, ano. Then, ang hinahanap natin, yung coordinates and distance after 2 seconds. Okay? Yan. So, given yung ating position in terms of time. Okay? So, position x and position y. Yung coordinates natin. So, yan yun. And para makuha natin yung x coordinate, so direct substitution lang yung 2 seconds na yun dito. Ito na. So makukuha natin is 1.0 meter. And also yung y coordinate, paano ba man yan? Okay. So yung 1 meter na yan ay nasaan yan? So let's say yan yung ating Cartesian coordinate plane, xy plane. So, nandyan daw yung 1.0 meters. So, nandito yung lander, nasa gitna. Okay, yung y component naman niya, so, may given naman equation, direct substitution ulit doon. Okay, so, napakadali. Doon lang. Then, makukuha natin si 2.2 meters. And, yun siya. And, nandun pala yung ating object, ano, ayan. So 1 meter from the lander with respect to x and 2.2 meters from the lander with respect to y. And the distance from the lander at 2 seconds, yun yung sunod na tanong. So distance formula lang kukunin natin dyan. Nakuha na natin itong dalawa. So distance formula, then makukuha natin si 2.4 meters. So alin siya dyan? Sa coordinate, yun yung R. The distance from the origin to the point, to the final point. The point at 2 seconds after, okay? So, yun. Next question is find the rover's displacement and average velocity vectors. Yan. So, displacement and average velocity vectors. For the interval t is equals to 0 seconds, 2 to 2 seconds. So, 0 to 2 seconds yung ating ia-analyze. Okay? So, ano ba yung displacement vector? So, displacement vector, yan yun. No? Yan yung kanina. Okay? And that is, when we say delta r, the change in position yan. And kung magkakaroon ng change in position, pag sabing change, magkakaroon ng difference, ano? Difference which is from 0.2 to 0.1. At yung 0.2, yung R sub 2, yan yung position at 2 seconds. And yung R sub 0, yan yung position at 0 seconds or at time t is equals to 0. Okay. And ano naman yung ating average vector? Average velocity vector. Ayan siya. Yan yung kanina. Okay. Average velocity is equal to delta R over delta t. Or it is the difference in position or yung pagbabago ng position per time interval. Okay, yun yung average velocity from point 1 to point 2. Ibig sabihin, point to point itong average velocity. So, unlike dun sa instantaneous velocity, at certain point siya, at a given point, at a given instant. Okay, so alamin muna natin yung displacement vector. So, paano makukuha yun? So, siyempre, kailangan pa din natin yung position na nagbabary in time. So, yung x, y, na nagbabary in time. Given yan. Okay? And, paano natin makukuha yung R? Yung mga R. Kasi, dalawang formula ang kukunin. Dalawang formula. Ito yon, yung R sub 2 and yung R sub 0. So, gagamitin natin itong unit vector form for R. Okay? So, R is equals to xi hat plus j yj hat. Kung merong z position in terms of time, so madadagdagan lang ito ng plus z k hat. Okay? Yun lang. Madadagdagan lang yan. So, anong value ng ating x? So, kitang-kita naman, ito yon. So, substitution lang dun sa x na yun, no? And then yung y, ito yon, substitution lang din dun sa y na yon. Okay? So, ang mangyayari dyan is ganitong equation na. Ayan. 2.0 meter minus 0.25 meter per second square t squared quantity multiplied by i hat. So, ito yung ating x coordinate na nagbabari in time. Ito siya. Yan. Okay. Lahat yan, yung buong yan na andun dapat. Okay? And plus 1.0 meter per second t plus 0.025 meter per second cube times t cube quantity times j hat. So, yan din yung y component or y position component ng ating movement. So, ito yon. So, y nasa j hat kasi y ito. Y component. Ano? Okay. So ang sabi is, ang ina-analyze natin is from 0 to 2 seconds. So, direct substitution lang din. Para makuha yung R sub 2, ay substitute natin ito. Para makuha yung R sub 0, substitute natin ito. Okay? Okay. Gawin natin. So, at time t is equals to 0.0 second, the position vector R sub 0 is, ayun lang, oh. Substitution lang nitong 0, ayun, oh, ito, substitute lang natin dito. Diba? And also, substitute din dito and dito. So, ganyan yung mangyayari. Okay? So, kung 0 ito, okay, kung 0 na ito, cancel na to. So, 2 na lang itong i. And kung 0 din itong dalawa, buo yan, 0 yan. Kaya naging 0 na lang to. Okay? And kung meron tayong xy plane, so, nandyan yung ating t is equals to 0.0 seconds. Nandyan daw. So, bakit nandyan sa x-axis? Dahil yung y niya ay 0. So, nandun siya sa 2. 2 meters. And yung y-axis niya, y coordinate niya is 0. Dahil 0 ang nakuha natin doon. Okay, next is the position vector R sub 2 at t is equals to 2.0 seconds is, yan yung nakuha natin kanina. Nakuha na natin yung kanina, ano? So, nakuha nating x component doon na 2 seconds. Substitute lang dito yung 2 is 1. Okay, and then yung y naman, substitute natin yung 2 dito, okay, is 2.2. So, meaning, kung ito ay 1, And then yung taas is 2.2. Malamang nandito yon. Okay. Ayun, tama, nandun nga. So, yun lang yung coordinate, ano? And ang tanong is displacement vector. So, paano kunin yung displacement vector? Nakuha na natin ito, R sub 2 and yung R sub 0. So, difference lang ng dalawa, makukuha na natin yung displacement, okay? So, direct substitution lang dito sa R sub 2, itong nakuha natin dalawa. So, we will get the answer, negative 1.0 meter I hat plus 2.2 meter J hat. So, yan yung ating displacement vectors. Okay? But how about the average velocity vectors? So, average velocity vectors, yun yung delta R over delta T. Okay, nasan yun? Ito yun, oh. Yan. So, nakuha na natin yung delta R. Yun na, ito na. So, napakadali lang kunin yan. Delta T is 2 seconds minus 0.0 seconds. Okay? Yun na yun. Ayan, oh. So, in vector form, since vectors yung tanong, displacement and velocity vectors, so dapat naka-vector form. Okay? May i-hat and j-hat siya. Okay? Ayan. So, yung nakuha natin delta R, ito siya, ito yon. Then, dinivide lang dun sa change in time or the delta T, 2.0 minus 0.0. So, then, makukuha natin sagot is ito na. So, negative 0.5 meter per second i-hat plus 1.1 meter per second j-hat. Okay, yun na yung sagot. Napakasimple, ano po. Okay, next question is find a general expression for the rubber's instantaneous velocity vector. So, ano ba yung tinatanong? Instantaneous velocity vector, meaning ay equation, general equation or general expression. So, since may given tayong position x and position time in terms of t, so makukuha natin yan. Okay? And then, express the velocity at t is equals 2.0 seconds in component form, and in terms of magnitude and direction. So, tatlo. Isa, dalawa, tatlo. Tatlo yung ating ini-aim na sagot. Okay, start natin. Ano ba yung given na ano? Position and xy. Xy position in terms of time. So, yan yun. Nasa taas. Okay? So, ito yung ating instantaneous velocity vector. Okay? In terms of vector yan. Yung naka-unit vector siya. So, yan yung velocity, instantaneous velocity. So, dapat nakaganyan ang form na makuha natin. So, paano makukuha yan? Ang una nating hahanapin is the bx and by. Pero, hindi natin makukuha agad yan. Dapat, alam natin ito. So, alam naman natin yan. Ano ba yung ating v sub x? Yun yung velocity natin with respect to x, and yung ating b sub y, velocity with respect to y. So, given in terms of time silang dalawa, meaning ito ay dx over dt, and ito naman isa ay dy over dt. Okay, napakadali lang. Derivative lang. Tapos naman na kayo sa differential calculus. Alam nyo na yan. Okay. So, magiging ganyan yan. Bx over dt. So, dx dt, ito ay nakuha lang dito. Dinerivative lang yan. Okay? And ito ay nakuha lang dito. Dinerivative lang yan. Okay? Okay. So, yan na. And then, therefore, yung kanyang general expression for the rubber's instantaneous velocity vector ay ito. Ito na. Yan na. Direct substitution lang. Itong bx at by. Ito yung general. Ayan. Yan yung general expression natin for the vectors, rubber's instantaneous velocity vector. Okay? And then, express the velocity at 2.0 seconds. So, substitute lang din eh. Okay? Nung 2 seconds. So, makukuha na natin yung velocity. Okay? Okay. Ayan. So, yan. Then, b sub 2x. Oh, yun na yun, oh. Ito yun, oh. Sabi ko nga, substitute lang natin dito yung t. Yan, ito yun. Yung t na 2 seconds and yung 2 seconds. Then, makukuha natin yung b2x or the velocity at 2 seconds with respect to x-axis na negative 1. So, direct substitution lang dito. Okay? And yung ating velocity at time t2 with respect to y-axis na 1.3 meter per second. So, saan ito nakuha? Ito lang yun, oh. Which is ito yun. Yun yung y component ni vector velocity. Okay, ni velocity vector. Okay. And yun na ba yung ating sagot? So, ang sagot dyan, dun sa express the velocity in component. So, substitute lang natin ito. Ang magiging sagot dyan is negative 1. Negative 1.0 meter per second. Plus 1.3 meter per second j hat. So, yun yung sagot dapat dyan. Okay? In terms of component form, yung in component form. Okay. How about naman kung in terms of magnitude and direction? So, napakadali lang din. Pinag-aralan natin noong vectors tayo, nagbe-vectors tayo. Regarding unit vector, ano? So, magnitude, simple lang. Magagamit ka lang ng Pythagorean. And yung direction, kukunin mo lang yung angle. Angle with respect to the y-axis. Okay? Yan. So, next. So, paano yun? Ganito ang gagawin natin. So, nakuha na natin yung b sub 2x and b sub 2y. Yan yung velocity at x-axis and y-axis component. Ano? So, which is negative 1.0 meter per second yung b2x and 1.3 meter per second yung b2y. So, paano yan? So, parang ganun lang din dun sa ating projectile motion. Nagpa-Pythagorean theorem. So, ganito lang yan. Pythagorean theorem. Okay? Okay, but let's say, i-grab muna natin, ano? So, para malinaw. So, ganito yung movement ng ating motion, ano, ng ating, nung nagsosorbay, or nung rubbers, ano? So, in XY plane, so, at time t is equals 0 seconds, nandyan siya. And at time t 2 seconds, nandun na siya sa taas. And meron siyang B2X. Yan yung negative. Yan yun. Yan yung velocity natin with respect to x-axis. And yung kaya naging negative yan kasi papunta doon. Okay? Kasi diba, rightward tayo ay to the right ay lagi tayo ay positive. Ano? Okay? And yung ating velocity with respect to y-axis at time t2 is pataas since positive to. Okay? And ang tanong is the magnitude. Magnitude ng ating velocity. So, paano makukuha yung magnitude niyan? So, yun yan. Yun dapat. Yun yung lumabas na yun. Yun yung velocity natin. Ay, di paano yun? Magpa-Pythagorean theorem tayo. Kasi ito ay parang ganyan na nangyari. So, ito yun. So, ito yung ating velocity. And ito yung by. And ito yung bx. So, para makuha to, Pythagorean theorem since 90 degrees to. Okay? So, ganyan ang mangyayari dito. Square root b sub 2x squared plus b2y squared. So, direct substitution lang yung nakuha natin value kanina dito. Then, makukuha natin si 1.6 meter per second. So, ito na yung value noon. Yan. Yan na yung value niyan. Yan yung b sub 2. And yan na yung magnitude ng ating velocity after 2 seconds. And how about the direction? Paano natin kukunin yung ating direction? Okay. So, ganito yan. So, di ba, natatandaan nyo, tangent ng alpha or theta or angle between the horizontal and the velocity is equal to the b sub y over b sub x. So, therefore, yung alpha natin is arctangent ng b sub y over b sub x. Ayan na siya. So, yung b sub y, eto siya, 1.3. Kaya 1.3 yan. B sub x, negative 1.0 meter per second. Then, we will get the answer of negative 52 degrees. So, saan yan? Paano yan? So, negative 52 degrees because yung ating velocity ay yan. So, with respect to horizontal. So, clockwise direction. Clockwise direction, kaya negative. So, kalimitan sa engineering, bearing yung hinahanap. So, with respect to horizontal tayo lagi. With respect to vertical axis. So, ito yung ating bearing. Ito yung ating bearing talaga, which is theta. Okay? Ang nakuha natin ay ito, which is negative 52 dahil nga clockwise direction. Okay? Ito yung target natin. So, paano yun? So, 38 degree kasi 90 minus 52 is 38 degree. Okay? So, 38 degree west of north. West of north. So, tama. Ito, ano? West of north. Ito siya. Or northeast. In other words, northeast. Okay? So, ito yung ating final answer. Okay, yun lang. See you on the next video dun sa ating next topic. Okay, thank you.